Make a table format by 48 number of sum and just you can solve it. It's very easy, so I'm not solving anymore. Now from the second sum, the sums are a little trickier, so I should go on that. So I'm clearing my screen. If you want to take the screenshot, please take the screenshot very fast. These are one type of one number sum. You can just solve like that then. So next sum here, write the following in the decimal notation. Now decimal notation means in the denominator part, suppose 2a I am starting. Okay. In the denominator part, we need to just make it as 10 or the multiple of 10. Okay. Now here we can easily see that if we are just going to just multiply this fraction, again you have started just okay. The problem is some students are like that. They are just never listen. Never listen. How many times I'm just going to tell them to speak themselves mute? Rather, you all be muted. So, here we can just see that if we are just going to multiply the denominator by 4, the denominator is easily come as 100, right? So, numerator also we will multiply. So, 16 by 100, and this is very easy. Previous day only I told. If this is the scenario, what we will do, 0.16, we can write. This is one procedure I told. The next procedure is a little tricky, but please don't raise your hand. I will not entertain. Listen to it very carefully, then only I will see. Just don't involve your mind in the raising hand. I will give enough time to write it down. That time you will please write it down. So the next procedure is just 4 by 25 is your fraction. Suppose I am just going to divide 4. Now here in this case, division is not possible because 4 is less than 25. 4 choto number 25 is taken. So I make the decimal anbo. Decimal, so for that decimal 10 we will get. Decimal is having a power that this decimal can produce 10 on each day. Okay. So 25 ones are 25. Now how much it is giving? It is giving 15. Now again, this for this decimal, we will get 10 and 25, 6 are 150. Okay. So this is the next procedure. Any procedure you can follow. Or rather, this division procedure you can do because division procedure is much more easier to do. I will show more sums. Please copy it down. Copy it down very fast. B sum also I am starting over here. 12 by 8 is there. By just reduce, we can reduce this. Reduce this. So this is 3 by 2. Now we can just do one thing. We can just, in the first method, if we are just going to solve it, we can just, not 50 by 5 only, it will be solved. So we can just multiply it like that. So 15 by 10, that means here 1.5 very easily because 10 is there. So the decimal we will count from the right side from here. One place we will leave and we will put the decimal. Or in the other procedure, 3 by 2 divide. Please watch the videos after the class. Okay. I'm just doing it by red because here black is there. Two ones are 2. One is the remainder. So we will put a 0, 0. Now two fives are 10. 10, writing 10 is not possible over here. So we got the decimal as it is. Please write it very fast. We will be going to the next sums. Rest of the sums, whatever I'm leaving, these are just back at your home, you practice. Like the way I have just given the chapter 3 chapter 4 or every chapter 4 also I will keep from today. I will send all the answers in the study material part, but give me some time. Write it very fast. I hope that both the procedure you have learned. If you have not learned, I am suggesting you to watch the YouTube videos, means this class recording again, so that you will be able to understand this. I hope you have completed. Okay. So going to the to the following in the decimal notation. So first three sums only you need to solve it in the decimal. Okay, so I'm clearing my screen. Okay, so 3a, this is given as 5 whole 1/2. You can do it is the improper fraction 11/2. Now the same procedure you can follow. 11, 5, 10, 1, decimal we are just giving. So 5.5. Okay. This can be your answer. Okay. Next is B. 3 whole 2/25. 79/25. Don't ask me how we are just doing this. Please watch the previous video. So 25/79 we are just solving. I'm so sorry. So 4. For that one decimal, we will put 25 up, and for that decimal, 10 will come. Okay. So 15. And for that decimal, again, we will get 0. And 6/6, it will go, and remainder is 0. So the decimal notation is 3.16. Similarly, the C's answer it will be 12 by 1 by 4. It will be 12.25. Okay, please solve this. Rest of the sums you will do it back at your home. 4 and 5 is also very easy. You will solve it in your home. I will go to the exercise B. Complete this. Okay, so I hope that you are done. So I'm clearing my screen. Rest of the sums are very easy, like writing words, and just from the words you have to write the decimals. Exercise B is also very easy. Few sums I'm showing. Again, I will just upload everything. Suppose question number A, 1A. Okay, just wait for a while. So here we will write 9.2. Here it is 0.36 equal to, I'm not giving. How I am doing? Suppose there is 4243 from, and here is 30. Okay, from the right hand side, how many zeros are there? We have counted already 3. So 1, 2, 3, 3 place we will go and we will put the decimal like 4.243. Like this way we can solve. So here we can just write like that 6 by 10, 1 whole 7 by 10, 3 whole 9 by 10, only 1 decimal place, 2 whole 14 by 100. By seeing only we can just convert it. Reducing the fraction is not mandatory while we are just converting from decimal to fraction and fraction to decimal. Okay. Yes, Srijita. Unmute.
Ma'am, number 2, we can also write 17 by 10, number B.
17 by 10, yes. No, 17, how it will be?
Ma'am, but in number 1, it was written like that only.
One whole. Yes, 17 by 10 also you can write, but before decimal, if there is some number, that is means that is the whole part. Like E sum, we can write 28 whole 43 by 100. Anything you can write, but better you should write like that. Whole number in the whole part and fraction part in the fractions. You know, you have to just, you can just... do anything, means convert it in the improper fraction or convert it in the mixed fraction. Choice is yours, but do it correctly, whatever it is. Okay. Okay, so question number 3, convert the following decimal numbers into a group of like decimals. Group of like decimals, that means you need to do like this. Okay, suppose 7.8, 7. Okay, just here I'm not writing, back at here 3a I'm just solving. 7.800, 3.990. Why I will tell? 1.242. Here this decimal is just all the parts of the decimal, means 10, 100 and thousands, all the places are filled up. So the rest of the decimal, this suppose this place, suppose this place, we will be filled up with zeros. So it will look like decimal. Very easy. Okay. So rest of the sums, I hope you can complete. Right now, you just complete B. Okay. So question number four also, I am just doing a little fast because we are having very little time to solve and much syllabus is also left. So question number four, which of these groups are decimals are like the same, that first group if we are going to see, these all are like fractions. Okay, this C is also like fractions, but rest E is not like fraction, B is not like fraction, again D is like fraction. These three are like fraction and the rest of them are not like fraction. Okay. So I'm just clearing the drawings. I hope you are done over here. So next exercise, I'm just going. Again, plotting this on the number line. So, if we are just going to see the fractions which are less than 1, those are just lying between 0 and 1. So rule number 1, you please write down in the copy, fractions less than 1 is lying between this is between, by the way, okay, line between 0 and 1. Okay, next question number 2, sorry, rule number 2 is, suppose the fraction is 1.2, so the interval should be 1 and 2, whole number interval. That means the fraction, if the fraction starting with that number, the interval should be that number plus that number and the next number. Okay, and so here we will write example 1.2. so here the interval will be 1.2 is lying between 1 and 2. That means the fraction starting the decimal starting number, this is the rules, you need to remember it. So clearly, if you are not writing, it's okay. Decimal starting number, and this is the next number. Next, this is next number. Okay. Now here, represent the following number in the number line. For this type of sum, you need to do one thing. You need to just convert it in the fraction. Okay, first you complete it. So here, this decimal is lying between 0 and 1. This decimal is lying between 1 and 2. this decimal is lying between 7 and 8, and this decimal is lying between 4 and 5. First you complete this, so we can go to the next sum. I'm just moving a little fast because I don't have any other choice. I will try to complete it by Wednesday so that we can start the next chapter. Because playing with numbers is very easy. Chapter 1-2 days only we will take. So I'm just clearing it. Okay. Suppose represent the following on the number line. For this type of sum, you will do one thing. Convert it to fraction and plot. The rules are same and plot. So convert in the fraction you all can do, and plotting also you all can do. So today in the question number 2 is your homework. You don't have to just, homework is everything, but this thing mainly you will just take out that you have to do. Okay, today's class is up to this. Many things today I have covered. Today after finishing my class only, you will just go through the entire ABC, 3 all exercise you will go through. Why? Because tomorrow I will take the class. That time, if any problem, if any misunderstanding, if anything you haven't understood, so that I can come back again and I can just make that thing happen for you. Yes, Prajushka, anything?
Yes, ma'am, in exercise A, number 1 and 4, 5, I can't understand.
Well, just watch the video today after my class. Means
four and five doesn't do that.
4 and 5 write in words means you need to write it like suppose 143.61.
Here I have one doubt that write the following as decimals. 4 tens. Ma'am, when I'm doing
you will write this, like that 143.6 tens and 100. Like that, or you can write like that 143.6.1. Anything. I think the second notation is much more easier than the first notation, right?
Five when I have doubt, even when I am just converting 9.3, that answer is coming like another answer.
9.3. That is recurring decimal. That concept we have not covered yet. So keep that sum aside. I will just I'm trying very hard to just give the starting materials every sums. So yes, if your ABC today I have covered. So today I will do one thing. First, I will give the starting material of this exercise. Okay, means chapter, this is chapter 4 or 5, whatever it is. This ABC I will give. Okay, in the night I will just post. Just give me a time. I will definitely do. Okay.
Okay.
Afifa, you are not doing the class very regularly. Is there any specific reason? I'm giving you the unmuting option. You don't like me. You don't like maths. You don't.
Ma'am, he is not in the class. He is not doing.
How you know?
Every class, keep the video off.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Keep yourself mute. All of you, please keep yourself mute. Tirna, keep yourself mute. Srijan, keep yourself mute. Okay, if this is the scenario, I should definitely. This session, you have seen that this is getting recorded. So obviously, I will inform the school. Now, school will take care the rest of the thing. Okay, there is a motive of my recording. Means it's not like that you have to just, you will escape me. Because I have seen personally that most of the students who are not doing the class, they are just complaining against me repeatedly. Because I really, it's